Greetings of the day. I welcome you all for the third session of the departmental elective analysis and synthesis of mechanisms. Let us summarize the last session where we studied about three approaches for kinematic synthesis. The first was motion generation or body guidance, where it is expected that the entire body of a coupler is to be guided through a prescribed motion with some sequence, which is usually termed as a floating body because it is not directly connected to the fixed link, and the corresponding input link, that is input crank or driving link, may or may not be prescribed directly. So, in the second approach, in a path generation, a point on a floating link or a coupler, a single point, any point, a single point on a coupler or a floating link is expected to trace a defined path with respect to fixed frame of reference. If the path points are to be correlated either with time or input link positions, the task is called as path generation with prescribed timing. But many times it also can be correlated with the input link. At that time one can go for the analytical approach to solve this particular problem. And last was function generation. So it is well known fact that a frequent requirement of design problems is that of causing an output member to either rotate or oscillate or reciprocate according to specified function of input motion, like motion of input crank or input link. So that means we are correlating motion of input crank and output crank. That is why it is called as function generation, which is nothing but correlation of input motion with an output motion in a linkage. So to simply put, first two approaches, that is path generation and motion generation or body guidance, are used to synthesize motion of a coupler and a point on it, whereas the last approach, third approach, which is function generation, is used to synthesize the motion of output crank with respect to motion of input crank. So now let us go for the detailed synthesis of four bar mechanism for the body guidance problem, that is the motion generation. Now here we have to consider the three various positions of a rigid planar body, which is nothing but a coupler. The meaning of planar body is the body here we are considering as a coupler containing the points A and B. And then the four bar mechanism for body guidance, considering the three positions of a body, can be designed graphically, and now it will be discussed here. So three positions of point, as the coupler is considered to be a rigid plane link, which is basically a binary link, consists of point A and B. We are going to consider or assume the three points or three positions of A as A1, A2 and A3, and three positions of B as B1, B2 and B3. Let us study this kind of example with respect to one case where link AB, that is coupler AB, is guided through three different positions. So now let us consider that a coupler, which is shown here, which is a binary link, which consists of the first position, which is shown here right now, which is A1, B1. This is the first position from which the motion of coupler should start. The second position with which it has to guide the, the link, which is A2 and B2. So A1 B1 coupler is shown here with its first configuration or first position, after some time it will go to its second position, which is shown here, and then third positions as shown here, which is inclined at some degrees, which is A3 and B3. So your coupler is expected to move from first position to second position like this, and from second position to third position like this. Now you should remember one important point here, is that length of this coupler at three position, obviously it must be same, because it is a single, it is a only one link, single link coupler, the same link which is going through three different positions. So obviously length of A1 B1, A2 B2 and A3 B3 is same, and which will be given in the example. Along with that, coordinates of A1, B1, like x coordinate and y coordinate of A1, x coordinate and y coordinate of B1, similarly coordinates of A2, B2, A3, B3 also will be given, so that these all are assumptions which are to be stated by the designer with respect to the application or the requirement which he wants to synthesize the mechanism. So that means if you start synthesizing a mechanism for body guidance, a four bar mechanism for body guidance, you must know what is length of a coupler, then which are the three distinct positions with which coupler has to be guided, and the respective coordinates of the endpoints of that coupler through three positions, that is coordinates of A1 B1, A2 B2 and A3 B3. So obviously if you know the coordinates of A3 B3, you will be able to find out the inclination at which this particular link is inclined, or angle at which this particular link is inclined. So now this is given as a example. Now what we have to do is, as the positions of coupler and link, length of coupler is known, we need to find out length of fixed link, which is not there, length of input crank, which is also not there, and length of output crank, which is also not there. So this information is only given. Remaining lengths of the links, remaining links, we have to find out using a graphical approach. Okay, so now let us discuss the stepwise procedure for graphical synthesis of a four bar mechanism using body guidance problem. So one point is to be noted, first of all, that position or the point A1, A2 and A3, all these three positions are to be coordinated with the fixed link, that is the one point on the fixed link which we can consider as point A, and another point on link fixed link B, fixed link will be considered as B. So we are considering fixed link as point OA, first point as OA and second point as OB. So now since it is a four bar mechanism, it is understood that connection of OA, that is one of the point on fixed link, should have coordination with position A1, A2 and A3. So that means A1, A2 and A3 are to be prescribed or coordinated with respect to fixed point, with respect to point on a fixed link, single point on a fixed link. Similarly, B1, B2 and B3 are to be coordinated with the another point on the fixed link, which is considered to be OB. And for A1, A2 and A3, the fixed point will be considered as OA. So that means what we have to do as next step is, we have to join point A1 and A2 by a line, then point A2 and A3 by another line, and now we have to find out a center of circle which is passing through A1, A2 and A3. With the center of this circle is nothing but your point OA. So For this, what we have to do is, we have to find out the we have to draw a perpendicular bisector to line A1, A2, and A2, A3. So now what we will do is, we will draw a perpendicular bisector to line A1, A2. So that means this angle will be equal to 90 degrees. Similarly, we will draw another line as perpendicular bisector to link A2, A3, which is nothing but this angle is obviously it will be nothing but 90 degrees. Now if you see the intersection of this particular line and this particular line, that is perpendicular bisector of A1, A2 and perpendicular bisector of A2, A3 intersects at single point. That point is nothing but center of a circle which is passing through A1, A2 and point A3. So can we label this point as fixed point, one of the point on a fixed line? Yes. So let us consider this as point OA. So now after this, as we have found out point OA, similar to that we have to find out another point on a fixed line, which is OB. So now since we have considered the three points at three positions of A1, A2 and A3 to find out the coordinate with respect to these three points as VOA, similarly to find out OB we have to consider three positions of B1, B2 and B3. Here also you must note that the circle must pass through B1, B2 and B3. That means radius from the center of for point B1, B2 and B3 must be same. So for that also we will join B1, B2 by a line which is shown by green color, and then again we will join point B2 and B3 by green color. After that we will draw a perpendicular bisector to line B1, B2. So obviously here also this angle will be equal to 90 degrees. Similarly, we will draw a perpendicular bisector to P2, B3 also, which is shown by, represented by this line. So now you can see here the angle will be obviously 90 degrees. So I'll repeat this procedure once again. We have joined B1, B2 and we have drawn perpendicular bisector which is shown by this particular line, and angle will be equal to 90 degrees. Similarly, we have joined B2 and B3 and we have drawn a perpendicular bisector to this particular line to represent this angle as 90 degrees. So now if you observe the intersection of this perpendicular bisector and this perpendicular bisector, it meets at, or it intersects at a single point, which is nothing but point OB. So we have now identified the two points with which the coupler is various positions of coupler is to be coordinated. Hence OA and OB will be considered as the, if you join OA and OB, it will be considered as the fixed link. So what we have understood from the intersection of these two perpendicular bisector is nothing but a rigid link OA. That is, if you join this point A1 and OA pinned to be to the body at point A and pinned to the ground at point OA will guide point A to its three positions as A1, A2 and A3. So that means if you join OA with A1, OA with A2 and OA with A3, you will get three configurations for link AOA. Similarly, if you join OB with B1, it will be first configuration for output crank. If you join OB with B2, it will be second configuration for output crank. And if you join OB with A3, it will be third configuration of output crank. So now let us join OA, OB. So this represents the fixed link. Now what I'll do, I will consider the second position of 4-bar mechanism, or second configuration of 4-bar mechanism, Hence, I have to join this OA with O2. This will be second configuration of input current. As we know, A2 B2 is second configuration of coupler, and if we join OB with B2, it will be also second configuration of output current. So at this current movement, the second configuration of 4-bar mechanism is shown. Now if you want to show the first configuration of 4-bar mechanism, you need to join OA with A1 and OB with B1. Or if you want to show the third configuration of your mechanism, then you have to join OA with A3 and OB with B3. So this will give you third configuration of your 4-bar mechanism. So now let us discuss the inferences which we have drawn from this graphical analysis or graphical synthesis. One must know the first point, that at the initial stage of the synthesis of this particular mechanism, only three different positions of coupler, that is A1 B1, A2 B2 and A3 B3 were known. No other specification for input crank, output crank and fixed link was given. So that means you must understand that graphical synthesis is completely independent of coordination of motion of input crank, output crank and fixed link. It is completely depends on how you are guiding your coupler from first position to second position and second position to third position. That is why it is completely considered as a body guidance problem, where the motion synthesis or body guidance is synthesized irrespective of motion of input crank, output crank and a fixed length. That is why you must have understood that orientation and dimensions in three different combinations for input crank, output crank and fixed link are determined by deriving it from the graphical configuration. So that is why the problem of body guidance is considered to be a complete motion generation problem, because the synthesis of coupler with three different points is synthesized irrespective of positions of other three links. So the conclusion of this particular synthesis is that if the three different positions of coupler are known, you will be easily able to find out the dimensions of remaining three links as input crank, output crank and fixed link. So this is the very simple and comprehensive approach with which the motion generation problem can be solved. So the two numericals for homework are given here. Synthesize a 4-bar mechanism to move the rod AB as shown in this figure. This rod AB is nothing but a coupler through three different position 1, 2, 3. So first position of coupler is A1, B1 which is given here. Second position is A2, B2 and third position will be A3, B3. So end points A and B are used to moving the pivot points. So that means point A and B are nothing but or are to be considered as the pivot points or the points on the fixed link. One point on the fixed link A and another point on fixed link is B. So coordinates, now if you can see here, you need a graph paper and instruments to solve this particular problem. Otherwise it is not possible to, if you don't have graph paper and instruments, graphical instruments, you will not be able to solve this problem. So on a graph paper you can take a suitable scale. Since all these dimensions are given in centimeters, so you may you, or you can convert, let us assume these dimensions are given in mm, so you will be able to draw it on the graph paper, or even you can like you can take suitable scale as you people used to take it in the you know take while they used to take when you used to solve the numericals of velocity and acceleration in term 1. So coordinates of point A1 are given as 2 and 32. So x coordinate of A1 is given as 2 and y coordinate is given as 32. Similarly for B1 it is given as 30 and 35. A2 it is 18 and 32. B2 it is 42 and 25. A3 it is 21 and 21. And B3 it is 46 and 16. So since x and y coordinates of all the points are given, that means with this you will be easily able to find out the distance between A1, B1 or you know distance, the length of this particular body or crank. As I have already stated that length of A1, B1, A2, B2 and A3, B3 is same because the same link is guided through position 1, 2 and 3. So try to solve this numerical using the same approach which we have studied. Now the second numerical is design a 4-bar mechanism to guide the door in and out with little rotation until it clears surrounding structure, after which it swings fully open to one side. The three positions of such door undergoing this type of motion is shown in the figure. Point A and B are used as moving pivots that guides the body through three different positions. So basically A and B are considered to be the moving pivots, and the fixed point can be considered as OA and OB as per your choice. So now if you can see here, the first position of this particular door is given as A1, B1, which is at this position, it is completely closed. The door is completely closed. You have to move this door to the second position when you are opening it. So we can say at second position door is partially open because it is not completely open, because this way is not completely open. You have to move from this side or like that. So this is partially open. And there if you can see the third position, A3, B3, it is fully open. So you have to find out a mechanism to coordinate these three positions of door. First position is completely closed, second is partially open, and third will be completely open. So you try to solve this example also with the same approach which we have studied. So now let us consider the demonstration of the solutions to real-time problems formulated by third year BTech mechanical students of batch 1920 using the same approach which we have studied today. The title is Synthesis of 4-bar mechanism for loading and unloading boxes by Nikhil Dhage, Neha Deshpande and Saili Joshi. So basically the problem which the students have considered and then they have given solution was of the loading and unloading of the boxes from conveyor 1 to conveyor 2. So it is used to carry the boxes from one position to third position, that is from one conveyor belt to another, and this can also be used to certain object has to be displaced from one position to another position or any kind of similar applications. So method used for synthesis of this mechanism is motion generation, that is rigid body guidance. So if you can see here, the bucket has been guided through, or it has prescribed three positions as at the start where the box is loaded into bucket. At this position you can see the intermediate position is this one, where it has to be carried from position 1 to 3, and at the end this is third position where the box has to be unloaded from the bucket. So considering the angular displacement of these three positions, you have to, I mean the students have synthesized the mechanism. Now I am going to play a video where my students have explained all the procedure, detailed procedure for this particular application. You just try to remember one most important thing, is that assumptions which you are going to made at the start for three different positions of a body which has to be prescribed through the path is very important in this study. The graphical procedure for synthesizing a body guidance problem is very easy. What is important is that how you are assuming the three positions of that particular body and you are initializing the problem.
Good morning, sir. My name is Neha Deshpande. We have done this project on the subject analysis and synthesis of mechanism. My group members are Nikhil Dage and Saili Joshi. We have fabricated and synthesized a four-bar mechanism for loading and unloading of boxes. We first found out a real-life problem. Then we try to find a simplest possible mechanism for it. We have also simulated it using Creo software, and at the end, we have fabricated. In industries, packed boxes are carried over the conveyor belts at the exit of production line. Due to space constraints, these conveyor belts are arranged one below the other instead of one single straight conveyor belt. So to load these boxes at the end of first conveyor belt and to unload it at the second, we needed a mechanism. Hence, we have synthesized a four-bar mechanism. Here in this figure, we can see this is the first conveyor belt and this is the second conveyor belt. And to load and unload these boxes, we needed a mechanism. The name of our mechanism is loading and unloading of boxes. The application is to carrying the boxes from one conveyor belt to another. Also can be used where certain objects has to displace from one position to another. The synthesis of mechanism is done using motion generation method, that is rigid body guidance. In this mechanism, rigid body is guided through three prescribed positions. In this case, three positions are at the start where box is loaded in the bucket, the second intermediate positions, and the third at the end where box is unloaded from the bucket. The rigid body is shown in three positions. To find the length of four links of mechanism, consider two point B and C on the rigid body 6 cm apart. This is our link 2. This link is drawn in three rigid positions. Three positions of this link are namely B1, C1, B2, C2 and B3, C3. Now B1, B2 and B2, B3 are joined. Also C1, C2 and C2, C3 are joined. Circle passing through B1, B2, B2, B3 is drawn by taking perpendicular bisectors of these two and taking their intersection point as center of circle. Similar procedure is followed for C1, C2 and C2, C3. These centers are given names A and B, and hence AB, BC, CD and AD are four required links of this mechanism. By this, we have found out the lengths of four links of our mechanism, that is AB 13.8 cm, BC 6 cm, CD 11.3 cm and AD 4.6 cm. There is one more part of this mechanism other than four bar mechanism. The necessity of this part is to give continuous rotating motion to crank to link of crank to link AB. So we have constructed crank and connecting link other than four bar mechanism. The synthesis is done in following steps. We have drawn a circle with center A and radius 5 cm. We have joined the point A and B3. Intersection of circle with link AB1 is P and intersection of AB3 with circle is Q. Line is drawn through PQ. An arbitrary point O is chosen on this line according to convenience and circle is drawn with required crank length 4 cm. By doing so, we have found out the crank length OM 4 cm and connecting link MP 9.5 cm. Here we can see the final diagram of our mechanism with crank OM, connecting rod MP and all other main four links of four bar mechanism, that is AB, BC, C and CD. The velocity and acceleration analysis is done for all the links using relative velocity method. In velocity analysis, first we assumed angular velocity for the crank AB. Then we calculated the velocity of link AB. Then we considered two fixed points A and D and a line passing through A perpendicular to AB having magnitude equal to velocity of AB is drawn. Then a line passing through D and perpendicular to CD is drawn. And then a line, then the two points B and C are joined in such a fashion that it is perpendicular to BC. And hence, at the end, we have got the velocities of all the links. Using these velocities and length of each link, we have calculated the centripetal acceleration of each link. And using that, we have calculated the tangential acceleration of each link and hence the tangential acceleration. Angular acceleration of each link. The result is shown in this figure. We have, as I said earlier, we have also stimulated it using Creo software for better understanding. And at the end, we have fabricated the mechanism and the fabrication is done by Nikhil Dalia. Thank you.